Hello, hello, hello to all my uniques out there. This is your favorite girl, Akido. Welcome to your unique wisdom. For today, we are going to talk about the Almighty Girl Code. So many of you have been writing and asking me questions, so I decided to talk about it. There is nobody on earth that can talk about this topic except my guest today. Chinwe Odonuju, welcome to Unique Wisdom.
Thank you, Unique. Thank you. I'm live today in the Unique Studio.
To all my returning subscribers, hello, welcome back. For those of you that are not part of my family, what are you still waiting for? You watch all the videos. You might as well come join us. You see the button that says subscribe? Click on that button. Wait for the notification bell. Click on that one too so you can be the first to see my video once they drop. Now let's jump into it. Girl code. What is girl code? Oh, he dated my ex-boyfriend. Oh, he dated my ex-girlfriend. Oh, he's dating my boyfriend's brother. Oh, he's dating my brother, my boyfriend's sister. Let's talk about it. Grab something to drink. I have my drink. I keep coughing, so we have something to drink. I have my juice. Get you popcorn. Get something to eat. We are going to sit down and we are going to actually talk. Come on, let us reason together, okay? Now, let's go. First of all, before we start, let's go to the definition. Look at the one I'm going to read, and then we go from there. It says, girl code is the unwritten and often unspoken set of rules and ethics that exist between a girl and her best friends. Okay? It says, simply stated, girl code are the commandments that outline the do's and don'ts of a good friendship. Whether the rules are implicit or explicit, they are generally what you can make or break a friendship. What's your thought on that definition?
I think so. You know, so you hear a lot of people say girl code. Mm-hmm. What is girl code? It's not in the constitution.
Yes, it's not.
Yeah, but these are sets of rules, or you know, like the definition said, these mm-hmm. are most times unwritten. Because it's not written. It's not like if you break it,
the world will come to an end.
There's going to be any penalty or any punishment. But these are, you know, just like how you know to knock before you go into somebody's room. You know, mm-hmm. and certain other rules like that. So mm-hmm. these are things that are meant to be known
and keep us also in check.
In check, yes. You know, sometimes people say, "Oh, you broke girl code," but mm-hmm. I mean. So because it is not written somewhere, it's as if there's no beginning or end to it. Yeah.
And it can move, it can change depending on the situation.
Yes, or the relationship.
It is not one size fits all.
Exactly.
It's not one size fits all because people always think it's one size fits all. No, it's not. Mm-hmm. Girl code is good. It's the unwritten laws and ethics that guide us. Okay, you shouldn't do this to your friend, you shouldn't do this to your girlfriend. But those rules can also change depending on who is involved, mm-hmm. what is happening, the situation that is happening, and things like that. Mm-hmm. Because, let me give you the next definition that I like too. This one says, they are the unofficial rules and friendship commandments of girl code. Wait until your friend is in the house. Like when you take your friend somewhere, you guys go out. When you come in, you drop your friend. You cannot drive off. You wait until she enters her house. Mm-hmm. So you're sure that she's right in there. Then you say, before you drive out, tell your girlfriend that her outfit, that she has a malfunction or it doesn't look good on her. You know, that thing you're wearing doesn't look good on you. Go change it, get something else.
Or your dress is ripped,
or your bra is showing too much cleavage or something. Then be the amazing photographer you wish you had. Take good pictures of your friend. You know your friend is not looking good. You know, women, we are the greatest enemies of ourselves. You know your sister is not looking good. And she said, take a picture of me. And you take it and her hair is like this. And she's looking like this. And you post it because you don't care. Mm. You know, women will normally do that. And then he says, what's the next one? He says, never go after your friend's ex. That's where we will start. Let us start with that. What do you think about never going after your ex's girlfriend, husband? Should you marry your ex's husband or brother or sister? Because I keep hearing girl code. What is your thought on that?
So this is what I think. Just because some of these rules are not written, right? And like I said, if you break these rules, nobody's going to put you in, nobody's going to throw you in jail. But this is more about courtesy and etiquette, right? So about my friends or relatives, exes or relatives, if I'm going to go out with a relative of my friend, I should talk to her about it.
Exactly.
All right. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, your brother is asking me out, or your cousin is asking me out. What do you think? Now, I have to stress that sometimes people tend to stand in the way of other people's happiness.
Happiness, exactly. Because she might say no.
Yes.
Don't date him, exactly. Yes,
for so many reasons. I've seen situations whereby maybe, oh, after all, I'm still single. Why would my brother go out with you and things like that? But you're telling her, you understand? And then in the case of exes, if I have a very good friend, if my best friend was dating somebody and they broke up, and that relationship was so bad, that guy was a jerk to her, I don't think I'll go out with him, you know. But let's say it didn't work out and they ended things amicably. Mm-hmm. Yes. I'm like, oh, girlfriend, you see, this guy is asking me out. What do you think? You know, you think I should give it a shot? I believe that I have people around me who are as mature as I am, who will think about it maturely and not be like, oh, I don't know. No, you don't go out with him.
What's your reason?
Why don't you want me to go out with him? You know. So if he's a good guy, if he's a nice guy, for some reason, people break up for maybe so many things.
Maybe we didn't connect. Exactly.
Irreconcilable differences. Exactly.
It might be just a small thing.
Yes.
So does he condemn the man or the woman?
Does it mean that I don't get a chance at happiness? Mm-hmm. You know, I feel like it's childish when you say, don't go out with him. Okay, why don't you want me to go out with him? Because I don't want to, because I said so. No. Who do you think you are? You know, so girl code, it's not a one size fits all.
It's not one size fits all.
Right. So I'd be like, okay, I feel like I'm surrounded by people who are open minded and who are mature in thinking, who will be like, okay, you know what? Why not? Go try. Mm-hmm. You know, you never know. Because life is too short. As you get older, you understand that chances at happiness become slimmer. So you grab whatever you got. Yeah. So you cannot tell me not to go out with somebody. You don't have any good reasons. If you're saying, oh, girl, don't go out with him because he's a serial cheater. Mm-hmm. He did this or he did. If somebody wanted my ex and I'm friends with him and a sister or a friend wanted my ex and he's a nice guy, why not? It didn't work out between us. And so it may work out between you two. I don't know. Who knows? Maybe this is your destiny. Who am I to say don't date him because I was a no.
And I wanted to say something here because my unique, those of you that are listening, I just wanted to say something here. The problem we women have is that in Igbo language, we say, Kamoga don't eat a kodrona for. I will not eat, you will not eat. All of us are going to be unhappy. The crab mentality, we are all going to be here. Nobody is going to leave this barrier. We are all going to be here. If I dated a man, my ex, or maybe I was married to a man, and the marriage did not work, it didn't work. You are not going to fight. And the man say, okay, this is not working. You go your way, Akudo, I go my way. I will feel somehow that human aspect of me, that maybe my sister or my friend will come and say, hey, this guy is asking me out. But guess what? I have moved on. Even if I haven't moved on, I know it. Let us be honest to ourselves. I know when I was in that relationship, I was not happy. I know when I was in that relationship, it was not working. I know there are so many different places where we do not agree. So you know what? If you want to date him, he's a nice guy. It just didn't work out. Why can't we do that?
Yeah.
And why will we always say, no, it's girl code, you should not date him? Why shouldn't you date him?
Like I said, if
he is the rib of your rib and the flesh of your flesh? Why wouldn't you date him?
Like I said, I think it borders on childishness and selfishness because why not? And again, people, you know, I feel like if you're a nice person, I mean, what's there? Why would you want to stand in the way of
happiness? Exactly.
It must be a sad time.
Because I have this, okay, let me throw this question to you. One of my units asked me this question. She and this guy have been friends. This is a guy. She is a lady. Two of them work together and they have been friends for like 6-7 years. They go to movie together. They go to their nightclubs together. They do everything together. but they have never dated. She says she had never seen this man as a potential lover. She has always depended on him. They have depended on each other, but as friends and nothing. They talk about their, you know, life and whatever. So the guy keeps saying, I need a friend. I need a girlfriend. You know, send me somebody. So this guy said, okay, I'm going to introduce you to my friend. So she introduced this guy to the friend and said, hey, this guy is a nice guy. I work with him. I've known him, date him. And they started dating. According to her, they dated for some time. But every time this man will come to her and say, your friend is good, but this, she doesn't do this. She doesn't listen to me like you listen to me. Mm-hmm. Whenever I'm with her, she doesn't, you know, understand my jokes. Whenever I make jokes, she asks me what's funny. But if it's you, you will laugh. Mm-hmm. You know, you understand me. I like your friend, everything, but I don't think we are connecting. And I don't know, you know, I don't think I'm happy and I don't think she's happy. So we were just going to call it off. So after a couple of months, they called the relationship off. Mm-hmm. But now, the question is now, the guy is telling her, it was when I started dating your friend that I realized that me and you match. So why don't, I think I'm in love with you, but I didn't even know I was in love with you. So why don't we date and see where this goes? Mm-hmm. And the girl was now asking me, what do you think I should do? She is scared that if she dates this man, her girlfriend will say she broke the girl code. She's scared that what if this man is her life partner? Is she going to miss this guy because of this girl code? Mm-hmm. So that's why I'm bringing this topic to you guys. What's your take on this question?
So this is my point. In this type of situation, okay, so first of all, I have to point out that some men are also satanic agents sent by the devil. So maybe, you know, so I mean, we know that there's a lot of promiscuity going on today. So maybe this man might have tested her friend and then want to test this other person. Mm-hmm. So if this man is serious, don't come at me with, let's see where it goes.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Don't come at me with, well, I need something more tangible than, let's see where it goes. Okay. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. And, you know, I don't tell people how to run their relationship, neither do I judge how, what people do, but I would say talk to your friend, tell your friend, listen, this is not what, or even three of you can
three
even
of
have
you
a,
can sit down,
you know,
together,
sit
yes,
together, mm-hmm, yes, and talk this out. I know that it is hard, but if you're mature, like I said, it has to do with
maturity.
If you're mature, that's okay, you know what, it's not working out. Life is too short for you to hang on to somebody who doesn't want you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there are over 7 billion people on earth. There are so many people who want, who may want you, but you don't even know because you're hanging on to
onto
the wrong
something
person
that is not working.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so just go ahead, have this conversation with your friend and tell her. And then with this guy, you have to be careful. He has dated your friend for this long, you know, and you guys, he's telling you that, oh, you are the one, you're this, mm-hmm, you're that, you're this. You have to be observant,
mm-hmm,
also. Don't just say, okay, well, he says he loves me and then we want to see how
because
it goes.
It might be a joke, too.
Yes, because in the next 7 years, he might say, okay, it's not you, now it's your mother. What are you going to say? Yeah, so don't just be careful with it because sometimes this man can be indecisive.
Yes.
I know what I'm saying. This man can be indecisive.
Mm-hmm.
There are so many men these days that are called serial bachelors.
Mm-hmm.
It's a thing now.
Yeah.
They want to date everybody and they tell you, I'm just testing. What are you testing?
What? How long?
This is not a cross.
How long? Is it a good season?
Is it that you know you don't
is
know?
Is it chicken pot pie that you keep testing and testing?
What did I call them? Satanic agents.
So my sister, the unique that wrote me, I said I was going to get back to you, but I didn't. So this is your video. I want you to know you heard what she said. My own opinion too is the same thing she said. Sit your friend down and talk to your friend, your girlfriend. Tell her, hey, this guy wants to date me now. And, you know, I want to make sure if it is real and it's genuine and I feel the same thing that he feels for me, I will want to take a run at it.
Mm-hmm.
But I wanted to tell you, normally, naturally, she will tell you no. She will say no. Oh, you betrayed me. You broke the girl code. Who made this code?
Yes. Well, as long as two of them, well, if they are still in a relationship, that is different. I think if they are still in a relationship.
No, they have broken up. She said they have broken up now for 2 months.
Yes, if she says no and she doesn't give you a concrete reason why she says no, then I think you should begin to question your relationship with this girl.
Yeah, because if my mom will always tell you that people we call enemies of progress.
Satan.
We call them enemies of progress because they will not eat and they will not let you eat.
Right.
They are not happy and you will not be happy.
Yeah.
So if you know that it's not working out, and according to the lady said this guy explained to her that you know in your heart this is not working out.
Mm-hmm.
I have given it my best, but it's not going.
Mm-hmm.
So you go your way, I go my way. If he wants to try, you know, date your friend and marry your friend, it's okay. But it would be sad, you know, for the girl to say, if you still talk to your friend and your friend still says no, then she's an enemy of progress.
Yeah, you need to reevaluate your relationship.
Another thing, my sister, please, before you jump into any relationship with this man, make sure this man is serious about you. Because I know what I'm talking about. Like she said, this man might say, oh, since I have not been with her friend, maybe I was wasting my time all this while being her friend. Mm-hmm. Let me also go be with her.
Yes.
No, so be very careful.
And then in the next 7 years, he says, oh, you know.
That is your mom.
It's not, you know, in your heart that it's not what, you know, men have a habit of repeating the same thing. No, it's not working.
So
I think your mom is the one.
Then it will be your sister. It will be this. So you be very careful, my uniques. Girl code, I believe it is good in some areas. Like one of the things said, you make sure your girlfriend, if you guys go out on a date and your girlfriend, you drop your girlfriend, make sure she gets into her house safely
before you drive off.
That's a good girl code. When your friend is having a malfunction or doesn't look good or what she's wearing is showing too much, the girl code, you should respect that and say, hey, honey, that is too this or your...
Be honest, but don't be crass.
Be honest, but don't be crass. Don't go about explain that to them so they can understand.
Well, yes. So you dress up and then, except you have gotten to some level. I have a best friend that is a mad person. I know she sees this video. she will probably cuss me off. But that is the nature of our relationship. So sometimes you just... I wear a dress and I'm like, lose weight. So, but she and I, we've been friends for a very long time.
You play like that. Yeah, so it's different. Like that,
you understand? But you can't be crass with your girlfriend. You know, you're saying things like, oh, girl, how do I look? You say, no, you're too fat for this dress.
Mm-mm.
That's going to hurt her feelings.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can say something like, you know, this dress, I think it doesn't flatter your figure. I think
exactly.
We should get something that flatters your figure and, you know, shows off your
good
parts, you know.
And then you pay some people, I've noticed with women. I don't know why we do this, and I'm going to ask you this question. Women never give women compliments, except there is a but. Example, oh my God, Chiwe, that dress looks good on you, but had it been it was green, it would have been your color. Oh, Chiwe, your glasses is so pretty, but had it been, there is always a but. Why do we do that? Especially the women, why do we do that?
I think most women who do that are women who are insecure. You know, they always, you see, the thing about insecure people is that they're always looking for something in the picture that will ruin a perfect, something that will ruin a perfect picture, all right? So if I'm insecure, I just want to give you the but so that you understand that, oh, you're not all that, or you're not all that perfect, all right? So I'll say, you know, but the thing I say to this is, if you're telling me about my butt, who is telling you about your butt?
Exactly.
If you say things like, oh, you know, Chiwa, that dress is really pretty, but if you wear green,
yeah,
I didn't see green in the market.
I didn't see green, green
is not even my favorite color.
And I don't want.
I know
green.
Why I got this.
Exactly.
You know, why can't you just say, oh, it's pretty, and then leave it at that?
I leave it at that.
You know, maybe that when you go to the store to
you
buy your
green.
Own, you can get green for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Just pay a person a compliment and leave it like that. Sometimes I think what you're saying has to do with, like I said, so many people that you see that are jealous, envious, is coming from lack of self-esteem and lack of confidence. You know, that's the only reason why somebody will be, because if I'm confident or if I think I'm just as gorgeous as you are, I shouldn't be jealous. You know, I should not be jealous. Oh, you're fine. Oh, you might be slim and you see me now. Let us leave the words.
Let us leave it like that.
Let us leave it
so
like
my
that.
Sisters, you know, I believe in girl code. I believe in us being sisters, keepers. I believe in us taking care of each other. I believe in making sure that if you go to a club with your sister and you notice that your sister is drunk, she has
don't
been drinking, don't live without her. Don't leave the party or whatever. You know what will happen to her. Or you see your sister being dragged by some men up somewhere. Don't go there. You don't go with your sister. Protect your sister. But please, when it comes for relationship, make sure you are obeying the girl code honestly and not just doing it because you don't want your sister to be happy. But there are some people too that will say, no, if you have dated this man, you are my girlfriend, you have dated this man. The reason why I don't want to date this man is not because the man is bad, but because I don't feel comfortable, because forever you're going to be my friend. Forever you're going to be in my house. So do I trust this man with you? So that is the next one we're going to talk about. What we're going to talk about now is, let us say you broke the girl code and you are married to your best friend's husband, ex-husband. The marriage is working perfectly. Do you still maintain the relationship, or do you keep your friends away from your friend away from your relationship? What's your deal on that?
Yeah, like I said, you know, it has to do with a certain level of maturity.
Mm-hmm.
If this person is with my friend now, if my ex is with my friend now,
mm-hmm.
then she is with my friend now. I should respect that.
Okay.
And if I'm such a good friend, I should make sure that I don't do anything to betray her trust.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I say, okay, let's say it was me.
Mm-hmm.
And I say, okay, you know, I'm going to keep my friends off. I'm going to keep it. It borders on trust.
It's trust. So that means you don't trust the man.
Yeah,
and you don't trust your friend.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But if I do, and we've already had this conversation, and it's, you know, everybody is in agreement,
mm-hmm.
I don't see anything wrong with saying, okay, we can still maintain this relationship, except I see reasons not to.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? And if I see reasons not to, I cannot say, okay, you know what, I'm going to keep my friend off of my man. You know, because I know so many people might say that this sounds naive, but this is what I think. Mm-hmm. I can't keep my man away from women. That's mm-hmm. just the truth.
Mm-hmm.
If he's not my friend, he's going to be my sister.
Mm-hmm.
So what am I going to do? Am I not going to bring any woman to the house?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I should be able to trust the man that I'm with. So if he breaks that trust, then it's on him. And then I'll have to deal with it based on the fact that it's on him. I have to decide if I want to go on or not. Because, I mean, why would I stay with somebody I cannot trust?
Okay, let me ask you another. Let me throw in something else to that.
Okay.
What if, let's say, for example, your best friend, let's say your best friend is Chidinma.
Mm-hmm.
And Chidinma was married to this guy for 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't work out. The guy is not a bad guy. Your friend is not a bad guy. Mm-hmm. It just did not work out.
Mm-hmm.
So now they are divorced. And Chidinma's husband is now coming for you.
Mm-hmm.
And everything about you and Chidinma's husband worked perfectly. Well. It works well. Chidinma's husband has proposed to you. You guys are getting married. You had a wedding. Chidinma came to your wedding. And after the wedding, she went back. Now you are happily married with Chidinma's husband.
Mm-hmm.
But Chidinma is your best friend.
Mm-hmm.
So he keeps coming to your house. But the problem now is that because she was your husband's ex-wife, some men have that mentality, like, because I've had you before,
mm-hmm.
you know, I can still have you whenever I want.
Mm-hmm.
So now, do you trust Chidinma? Do you trust your... Do you actually believe in your heart of hearts that if Chidinma and your husband can be left alone, can they be actually trusted?
So, it doesn't really have to happen in my house.
I know, not in your house. I'm saying,
yeah.
Since you are married to... It can happen anywhere, but yes. That's what I'm saying. Do you actually trust that if that marriage is over, it's over? Chidinma and your husband can never go back together again.
Okay, so personally, mm-hmm. personally, it's either I trust the person or I don't.
Okay.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So if I've decided, if we've had this conversation and I trust Chidinma, I trust my husband,
mm-hmm.
There's nothing I can do about it, really.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand what I mean? There's really nothing I can do about it, because if Chidinma doesn't come to my house, they might meet elsewhere. So it's better if I know that from the get-go, I'm not going to be able to handle this situation maturely. It's better I don't even get into that union.
Yeah.
Because even if it's not with the fact that it's still mass exes, it's not even safe, or it's not even healthy to marry a man you can't trust in the first
exactly.
place. You understand? So if it's not Chidinma, it will definitely be another
somebody
woman.
Somebody else, exactly.
You know, so the bottom line is, don't even go into it with somebody that you cannot trust. If you know you cannot trust him, then don't go into it. Because... Mm. The truth is, you can marry somebody who is not Chidinma's exes, but he's a serial cheater.
Exactly.
He's still going to cheat on you, whether they're Chidinma or not.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say he wasn't even married to Chidinma,
mm-hmm.
or he has never dated Chidinma before.
Or doesn't even know Chidinma.
Or doesn't know Chidinma. Mm-hmm. There's also a possibility that Chidinma can visit me and he starts to make a go at Chidinma.
That's true.
So it all borders on trust. If I don't trust you, there's no point in wanting to be with you.
Mm-hmm. And that was the reason why I raised that topic, my friends. The reason why I raised that, my unique, is because I have told of, that's why I say this girl code, it depends on the situation.
Yeah,
it's not one size fits all. Because I have been in situations where people say, no, I will not marry my girlfriend's ex. I don't care whether it's trust or no trust. I can, because me personally, they tell me, me personally, I will not trust them. And that idea of not trusting them is too much pressure on me. So I don't want it.
Right.
You know, like for me personally, when I was in college, yeah, it's in college, one of my best friends, my very, very good friend, she was dating this guy. The guy was a prince-to-be, and the guy would take them out. And the guy, whenever the guy comes to take her out, she would tell me to come on, let's go. And whenever we go, I'll be talking with the guy, we'll be talking and laughing, and the guy will say, oh my God, you're so funny, you're so funny. So whenever my girlfriend will go to the guy will tell my girlfriend, where is your friend? My girlfriend will say, oh no, she didn't come. She said, oh no, no, let's go get her. You know, she's the life of the party. We're going to laugh. Let's go get her. Then they will come to my house and pick me up. So every time he will say, let's go get her. So after he has dated my friend for like 4 months, my friend now told him, I'm sorry, I'm not feeling you that much, even though you're a nice guy, but I can't marry you. I already like somebody else, so I'm going to marry that person. So the guy was devastated. He was like, why would you do this to me? You know, blah, blah. So he kept coming to me to tell me, look at what your friend. I said, well, she loves the other guy. It's okay, just move on. And then he now told me, oh, no, because all the time it was me that kept them together, that I was the one that was cracking the jokes. I was the one that was making everything fun, so that he really thinks we should, you know, go at this. I said, no, no, no. But no, 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 no. You ain't going there.
Let us not go there.
Let us not go there, please, bro. He said, no, it doesn't matter. This, that, that, that. I said, no. It's not that I'm going by girl code. It's just that me, personally, I can't handle it. Because I know how you worship this girl. Mm-hmm. I know how you love the ground she walks on. Then how will I feel? Because she's still going to be my friend. Mm-hmm. And she's still going to come to my house. So I don't want every night I'm doing FBI. Going to go sneak and see where you people are.
The most important aspect of a relationship.
If I wake up in the middle of the night, you're not in the bed. I want to go crawl. I see where.
And you see, there's nothing wrong. And that's my point. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. So I personally decided I didn't want it. It had nothing to do with the girl code or whatever. But for me, I could not handle it as a person.
Yes.
That's why I tell you guys, it's not one size fits all.
Yeah, do you. If you can't handle it, that's fine.
You know, if you think you can handle it and you think, oh, you know what? I like this guy. And your girlfriend said, whoa, he's good. Why would girl code make you stay away from your happiness?
Life is too short. That's the truth. Life is too short. Just do whatever you want, you can to hold. Listen, the truth is, as you get, I just had a birthday on the 1st of May. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I'm 80 years old. The truth is that, as you get older, you begin to see
life differently.
Mm-hmm. You understand? Maybe when I was in my 20s, I'm like, no, never.
No, girl code, girl code, because you're young.
Yeah, but then as you get older, you're like, okay, no. For some mature people, some things are more important than others. You understand?
Yes.
At this point, what's the worst that will happen?
Mm-hmm.
They have sex.
Mm-hmm.
Some people don't even have strength.
And the truth of the matter is, like you said, life is very short.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know where your happiness is going to come from.
You don't know where it lies.
You see, the Bible said the rib of your rib, the flesh of your flesh, there is only one for you.
Right.
And that is that rib.
Right.
So what if that rib
did not see you
the first time and made a mistake and married your girlfriend?
Mm-hmm.
And now he has divorced your girlfriend, or that one did not work. And now he has discovered you. So you're going to throw it all away because of girl code?
Hello?
Please, my sister, think. You're going to throw it away because of guy code? Some men will say, oh, no, you cannot date your friend's ex-girlfriend. What if the girl was not good for you? What if the girl was not meant for you? What if the girl is not your re? Is not your body of your body? It doesn't belong to you. You cannot take a square peg and put it in a round hole. It's not going to work. Then you want me, when I see now a square hole, you don't want me to put my head because you're saying girl code.
Right.
Guy code. No, guys, now let us
listen, if your friend doesn't want your happiness, like my niece will say, ta-ta.
Bye-bye. Yeah. Because the truth of the matter is, we should mature to a level in life where you can understand that if it doesn't work out for me, it works out for you.
Mm-hmm.
And girls, I'm saying this to my ladies, to my unique women. We are the only group that don't want each other's happiness.
Mm.
Men don't care. I'm telling you, a man will say, bro, I like this girl. Mm. You used to date this girl. Is she cool? The guy said, she's cool. Girl.
She's a good girl.
That is okay.
That's it.
But for we women, oh no, I am not happy, especially when they are not in a relationship. Mm. Why would you move on with my ex? So my sister, it is not one size fits all. Mm-hmm. Do what works for you. As long as you are not manipulative.
Yes.
Don't go and break up that relationship.
Just because you want
the guy. That's not it. If they have broken up and then the man finds you on his own, then that's different. But don't go start manipulating, trying to tell your girlfriend the man is no good so that you can divorce the man and the man can come to you. Or trying to go tell the man that your girlfriend is no good. Then that is not it. That's not what we are talking about.
Basically, don't be unfortunate and don't be a Satan.
That's not what we are talking about. So, my sisters, you had that one. That is the second part of it. Now, the third part of it I want to talk about is family. Is it okay to observe girl code in families? For example, I'm the senior sister. She's the junior sister. I was married or I was engaged or I was in a relationship. It did not work out for us. And now the guy comes back to come and marry the younger sister. How do you look at that? Is it possible? Can it be done? I've seen it happen. Okay.
I've seen it happen. I won't even lie. I've seen it happen, but it might be a bit weird to me because this is family.
This is family.
All right.
Friendship is different.
Yes, friendship is different. This is family. It's a bit weird. If it's my elder sister and then you were married to my elder sister, I already saw you as a brother.
Exactly.
So that would be like sleeping with my brother or marrying my brother. So it would be weird.
Yes.
It would be weird to me, but never say never. Never.
No, that is the Satan.
Like I said, I've seen it happen. Even the elder sister was like, yeah, go ahead. But for me, I think it would be weird.
For me, it would really be weird. Because I have seen where a sister...
Especially if I'm the younger sister, it would really be weird.
Yeah, I've seen where a big sister got married to a guy, but she didn't have children for the man.
Mm.
So when the man wanted to have children, she went and brought her junior sister. And her younger sister came and had children. I have seen it has worked.
Yes.
But it all depends on the circumstances.
And the settings, yes.
Yeah, on the circumstances. If your sister said, okay, you know what? You are a good man. I don't want to do anymore. But, you know, you can, since I like you, you can still go to, but then it's a different thing. Mm. But the question is, the sister might feel weird about it.
Yes,
because when you were married to my big sister, I saw you as a big brother.
Yes.
I saw you as a big brother. I saw you as an uncle. I saw you. So how will I turn around and now marry you?
I don't know. So especially if you guys had kids, it would be worse.
Uh-huh. So most of the time, when it comes to family,
you know, that would be too weird.
Yeah, that would be too weird because there's another story. Let me ask you about this story.
Mm-hmm.
These are two sisters. The big sister got married to this guy. So she went and took her little sister to come and live with her. She took her little sister when her little sister was like maybe 6 years old. So the little sister grew up in her house, went to college, and then one time the little sister told the big sister that she's pregnant. And the big sister was like, what's wrong? Who got you pregnant? Blah, blah, blah. Only for her to find out that it was her husband. The big sister have had three girls, but no son. And now the little sister was, so when she called her mom and told her mom, and she said she was expecting her mom to say, oh my God, why would your sister do this? Apparently her mother knew, and her mother said, does it matter? You don't have a son. You don't know, maybe this is a way of God giving you a son. So she was heartbroken and she cut off her mom, her siblings, and everybody, because everybody was like, your husband is rich enough.
Was she still married to her husband?
She was still married to her husband. Mm. So in that case, this is not even a girl code. This is just a weekend.
This is just betrayal.
That is just betrayal.
Cutting your mom off and cutting your sister off is not just it. The man that slept with your sister disrespected you.
He disrespected
you. Why would you go sleep with my younger sister?
My younger sister. And why would my younger sister
agree to this kind of nonsense? Yes.
And then why would my mom think it is okay?
It's okay.
If God wanted to give me a son, he couldn't give it to me except through my younger sister, through backyard.
I'll just relocate to Somalia and leave all of you alone.
So in that case, my sister, family, what goes for the friends is not the same thing with family.
A friend is
somebody that after friendship, they go, you go. They go home, you go home. But family is your real family. You see them morning, afternoon, night. They are eating. There's no way you can turn around and maybe take your sister's husband or take your brother's wife. That will be very weird. So for me, if there is a place where the sister code should be observed, it should be in family.
I think so. But again, you know, in the past, in the olden days, yeah, our fathers married women and their sisters.
And their sisters,
like,
yeah,
our grandfather.
Like, but that was the culture then.
Right.
Because when you come to a family and you were treated nicely, you will go bring your family. Because
especially it was polygamy.
It was polygamy. They were practicing polygamy. So it was a different ballgame.
Thank God I wasn't born in those times. I would have still moved to Somalia. I don't like polygamy. I don't like to share.
So in this case now, but here we are not practicing polygamy. Mm. Although now I'm noticing most men are not trying to go back to polygamy. I'm now seeing people on Facebook, on YouTube, trying to have 2 to 3 wives and showing it off. Sister wife has a show on TV,
yes,
where the man has like 3 wives. So now I think gradually people are not trying to go back to polygamy. When our fathers did polygamy in Africa and most of their sons said, no, this wasn't good.
We're not going to do this.
We're not going to do this. This is a lot of work. Yeah. And now gradually I'm noticing people are trying to go back to it. So if there's a place where girl code should be practiced, I think it's in family. Leave your sister's ex alone.
So I think what we should call it is sister code. Sister code it should be different.
Sister code should be different from girl code. Girl code is girlfriend. So that one should be sister code. You know, when we are sisters, there are certain boundaries, or brother code. There are certain boundaries. You can't go marry your brother's wife, your brother's ex-wife. Your brother's ex-wife.
Not me. I'm just remembering people that have done it. Like,
yeah,
well.
I know people have done it, but yeah, the truth of the matter is, if your brother is dead,
that's
and then
different.
You married,
yes,
it's different.
Yes.
But it's just like in a family, your senior brother divorced the woman,
yeah,
had 2 children, and she left. And then your junior brother went and married the same woman and had 2 children.
That is weird.
What is wrong with
that's
you?
Weird. They're not going to come home to the same place.
They're coming home to the,
yeah,
same family. So that's a little bit weird.
But again, the thing that, like I said, I just had a birthday and I feel like I just turned 80. I feel like, you know, there's a lot going on in this world today.
There's a lot. We have to be very careful.
Yes, there's so many circumstances, there are different scenarios, you know, you just don't know what works for this and what works for that.
Uh-huh.
So that's why most times when I talk on subjects, I say, for me personally, this is what I think I would do, you know, but because these other people, you never know. A woman might say, oh, it's okay for my younger sister to marry my husband. You just don't know. Some people are twisted and some people don't take things the way we think.
Yeah,
but for me personally,
mm-hmm,
it would really be weird.
It would really be weird.
Yeah.
But then, like I said, if there's anything like sister code, it should be observed. But there are some families that will say they don't care about the sister
code.
That's
what I'm saying. Yeah.
So if that's
like,
what
like
they
the
want.
The woman that went to bring her sister to come and give birth for
her husband. It,
yeah,
didn't bother
so
her.
Don't know what
because
does.
In her own case, her husband is rich.
Yeah.
So, and she was scared that if she brings an outsider, that would be worse for her. They might kick her out. So she thought her sister will never maltreat her, will never mistreat her. Mm-hmm. So that kind of stuff. So it all depends. That's why I tell you guys, like she said, life is too short. We take all these rules and limit ourselves. We take all these rules and limit our happiness, our chances. Just like people say, oh, I cannot date somebody from this state.
Yes.
I cannot marry. But that's
from
another thing
race,
I want us to talk
tribe.
About.
Yeah.
That's the 4th part of this girl code. I will not date somebody from this tribe. What if that tribe is where God has put your husband in?
Mm.
And you're going to miss your husband because of that tribe.
Mm.
Some people will say, no, I will never marry a Yoruba. I will never marry an Hausa man. I will never marry an Igbo girl. I will never marry from Anambra. I will never marry from another African country. I will never marry a Caucasian, a Hispanic.
Mm.
What if those people are, that is where God say it is there you will finish. Now you're finishing point.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What are you going to do?
Yeah, please. This is a public service announcement. If you are single, you are approaching 15, you are comfortable, you know how to use your tenses correctly, holla at your girl, I got something for you, okay? Race don't matter. Tribe don't matter.
Because
holla at your girl, I got you a package. I feel like it's limiting.
It's limiting. Yeah,
limiting.
I wanted us to talk. That's the part 4 of it. I wanted us to talk about
some people.
Yes,
yeah,
about
some people
that.
Have different of course, when you're looking out for a life partner or somebody to date or something, there are certain things you say, okay, this is what I want.
This is what I want.
You
uh-huh.
know? So, but you know, I think it's along the lines of things like, oh, I want somebody who has family values. You know, more concrete
yes,
things.
More concrete
integrity,
things. Yes. An honest man, a trustworthy man, a reliable man, not where he's from. Or what is the color of his skin?
And somebody who is, for me, I'm ageist. I'm sorry. That I know that's a bit similar, but I'm ageist. I would never go out with somebody that I'm older than. I don't know how to do that. Yes, I don't know.
You feel if you're older, you will not respect the person. Not if the person is younger, you might not respect
I feel
them.
My thing is, I feel like as I am, I'm already too mature for my age.
For your age, okay.
So men who are my age mates,
mm-hmm.
I feel like I don't know
mm-hmm.
if they... I'm not sure. So, you understand? Mm-hmm. So I feel like I just like people who are mature,
mature enough. And uh-huh.
So I feel like I know that maturity has nothing to do with age uh-huh. but you know, it's more or less is easier to find somebody who is older that is more mature than to find somebody who is younger and more mature. Yeah. The chances are higher. Yes, but like I said, life is too short to be sad. If you know you really want to be, you're the relationship kind of person, you're the kind of person that cannot survive on your own, then don't use these barriers and rules. And
we have so many rules.
Yes.
So many rules. Okay, you have this girl code, you cannot date somebody. If all your girlfriends, if you can't date their ex, who will you
who
date?
Is remaining?
Who is remaining?
They're only about, listen, let's say let's say there are 2 billion men on earth, okay? 30% of them are above 60. 20% of them do not like women. They prefer men. 30% of them are probably below dating age. They're below 20.
Mm-hmm.
Another 10% may not have a good job.
Mm-hmm.
So you're probably left with a little percentage. And then, in this percentage, your girlfriends have dated a fraction of this person.
What are you going to do? As long as you're not the one that is going out there and trying to destroy those relationships so they can come to you.
Yes.
But if it didn't work, my sister, I want to use this opportunity and tell you, relationship is not a do or die affair.
Right.
If it's not working, walk away. Some I have seen people that are so unhappy. They don't like where they are. But because of the society,
instead of them being alone,
they will just be coupled up and unhappy and sad and miserable. It doesn't make any sense.
I saw a very satanic and demonic post. They said, why build the relationship? Wait for others to build it and then you snatch it up.
You see? And this is a post somebody put out there. Why do
and this is somebody's mentality.
And this is somebody's. These are the people you are competing with.
Right.
These are the people that are dating people out there with you. Say, why build a relationship? Wait for somebody else to build it and then snatch it. Somebody put that thing as a post, and that person believes every word they wrote down there.
Mm-hmm.
So you are here trying to build a relationship. Like somebody else will just say, okay, are you done? Okay, boom, and take it and run. So that these are the people you're comp- and then now you want to put so many other rules.
Mm.
Barrier, we want to talk about where they are from, who they are, where, what they are looking at, who they are. All these are rules. Even though as an Igbo girl, I would want to marry an Igbo man. It makes it easy. I will speak the same language. We understand and respect the same culture. Values. We have the same values. So I can understand that. But what if, don't narrow it only on Igbo. What if there is no Igbo for you? So are you going to stay single until an Igbo comes? So even though, so if you want an Igbo, seriously, my sister, take a whole chaplet and go put it inside the ocean.
True.
Take two good chaplets in a very big basin and start praying. That God, please give me an Igbo man.
Yes.
So that way God will hear your prayer. But don't limit yourself. You have to let God direct you. What if God say, my sister, Igbo is not for you. Yoruba is for you. You say, no, I don't like Yoruba people. Oh, I'm a rock man. He said, no, God, I don't want it.
Yes, because, and then every other person you've married is not good
enough. Nothing is
you.
Working, exactly.
And the thing is this, would you rather have an Igbo man who is, I'm not saying Igbo people are abusive, I'm just saying, would you rather have an Igbo man that is abusive and makes you unhappy than to have a man from Somalia who makes you happy?
Who makes you happy? That's the most important thing.
You see, happiness.
Happiness is the most important thing.
I saw a post where somebody asked, what does marriage mean to you? I said, for me, marriage means loyalty. Dependency, and when I say dependency, I don't necessarily mean financial. I mean knowing that you're going to be there for me,
reliability. Yes, yeah, you're there for me.
Laughter and peace of mind.
And peace of mind.
I just want to be able to stay
know that if you go out there and hustle and bustle When you come back home, you are your safe haven.
Yes.
You know, you can relax and be happy, and there's somebody there to share.
And laugh. I love to laugh.
And laugh and be happy.
So, back to what I was saying, if you know you're a certain age, you're from Israel, and you are funny, you like to laugh, you have to survive, I got a package for you.
Okay.
I'm not necessarily saying it's me, just saying I have a good package for you.
My Unix, are you hearing that? All those men that are following me on Unix, you had that. If you are single and you're at 50,
no, we're well about that.
If you are,
no, you don't have to be 50.
You don't have to from 37 and above. Mm. If you're from 37 and above and you're looking for a wife and you want to be married, she says she got a package for you. Not me, I'm married.
He may not be me.
But he may not be her, but she might know somebody that she can connect you to.
So contact Unique.
Contact Unique. And
call this unique matchmaking.
All right, guys. I wanted to just come in and answer because all of you keep saying, oh, girl code. Yeah, girl code is a beautiful thing. We have to take care of each other. We have to make sure each other are safe. We have to make sure that when your sister is not looking good, be honest and tell your sister, that thing doesn't look good on you. Go change it. If you see something that is good for your sister, share with your sister. If you know that your sister wants you to take a picture of her, take a good picture of her. Don't be too fast to talk about your sister's secret.
Yes.
Don't be too fast to discuss your sister. Don't be too fast to find fault. We are so easy to find fault. Look at her. Mm. Look at how she looks.
Who does she think she is?
Look at her. That doesn't even look good on her. She's too fast. She's too slim. She's too tall. She's too
short. You see your friend. Oh, girl, you look good. And in your mind, you know that's not true.
You know that's not true. And you looked at her and know that dress makes her look so bad. Mm. But in your mind, you're telling yourself, oh, you look good. When she leaves, you don't go out there and go disgrace yourself.
Yeah, that's not.
We are the only ones that do that.
And if you go somewhere with your friends, with your ladies, you guys go for ladies' night or ladies, you want to go hang out or whatever. If you go together, make sure to leave together.
Don't leave your friend behind.
Check on your friend if she's on a date, because there are so many mad people.
There are so many mad people out there.
Yes.
When you're, and please, even you that is on a date, before you go on any date, remember to share your location with your friends.
Yeah.
Tell your friends, hey, where are we going? Oh, we're going to Papados. Which one? The one on Windy Hill.
Yeah.
Hey, call your friends. Hey, I'm going to Papados on Windy Hill. Check in on me in an hour.
Yeah.
Check in on me in 30 minutes.
Yeah.
We have to be better sister keepers.
Right.
We have to keep each other safe. We don't just say, oh, well, she's drunk. That's her business.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I don't care about her. When you see your sister being stalked by somebody, and you see it, tell her.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's talk about telling your sister if her man is cheating. That's the final topic before we leave. Is it okay? Is it included in girl code that if you find out your husband, your sister or your girlfriend's man is cheating, is it good to tell her? Is it good not to tell her? Which one?
So this is my point, okay? It depends. I think it depends. I wouldn't... there's no need bearing unnecessary news.
Okay.
You understand? Especially if they are happy. People make mistakes, right? I'm not excusing cheating. If you cheat on me, let's just leave it at that. But if I find my girlfriend's man or my sister's man cheating, I am going to confront him and tell him, look, you know, this thing that you're doing is not good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I want to be the person that will tell my sister or my friend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I want to be the person to bear the news to them. Except... they already having issues.
He's destroying stuff.
And she told me, oh, you know what? I'm going to end this relationship. And maybe I know that this man has gone to buy a house. And maybe he's marrying somebody out there.
Uh-huh.
This is really dangerous. And then I'm going to speak out. Other than that, I catch him. Let's say I go to a party and I see him with another woman. I'm going to call him aside and be like, what do you think? What are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is not good. You understand? Mm-hmm. But I don't think I'm going to tell my friend.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm gonna be like, okay, you know what? You should, if you're unhappy with my friend, you should do something about it. You should either, if you don't want to be with her, then don't be with her, but don't just be with her and then cheat on her. And then I'm gonna leave it at that. I don't think I want the news to come from me. One day, my friend might just catch it. But if I know, he's always in town, he's doing stuff, and he's becoming really embarrassing. I'm going
to
call my friend
to your friend.
And sit my friend down. You understand? But if he is there happy, and I don't think I want to be the... You see, sometimes people, you might think you're best friends with somebody. Have you ever given somebody news before and they ended up presenting you first?
And they won't speak to you.
You're like, ah,
you're like the bearer of... They will even call you the destroyer of the marriage.
Say you're destroying their marriage.
Exactly.
So I don't want to be the person that will bear such news. So it's something to be careful with. Mm-hmm. It's not just something you'd be like, oh, you know, girl, I saw your man. He was cheating. He was doing it. No, you want to be careful mm-hmm. with it. Because imagine also you, sometimes when we break certain news to certain people,
mm-hmm.
the ego comes in. Let's say a friend of mine calls me up and says, Hachi, I saw your man with somebody else. And like, you know, some people who are not mature be like, that man, I'm going to leave him. I'm going to deal with him today. You're just putting up a show for your friend. You know, that's not what you're going to do.
Exactly.
You know? And so sometimes that's not what you want to do. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, girl, are you going to leave him? I saw him with a girl. Are you just going to forget about him? No. So for this, there's no hard and fast rule. Apply common sense.
This is where common sense comes in.
Yes, apply
common sense. Is it for me? First of all, if I see my girlfriend or my sister's husband or boyfriend or whatever cheating, first of all, I have to make sure he is cheating and I'm not assuming that he's cheating.
Mm-hmm.
Because I walked into a hotel and saw my sister's boyfriend at the bar talking to a lady. That doesn't automatically mean he's cheating.
He's cheating.
That might be his colleague. He might be there for business. If I want to be sure, then I can sit back and watch if I want to. If I don't want to be sure, it's nothing. You move on. Everybody you see, the problem we have is that we human beings are so quick to judge.
Mm.
If you see me talking with a man, you don't know who the man is. Because that man is not Nelson does not mean I'm cheating.
Mm.
You don't know whether that is my brother. My brother is very dark. Mm. I'm fair. Mm. So if you see me and my brother, you will never know he's my brother. Mm. So you don't know whether he's my brother. You don't know whether he's my cousin. You don't know whether he's my in-law. You don't know whether he's Nelson's friend. You don't know. Mm. And then you are, you know, running your mouth. I remember when I came to America newly. Let me tell you guys this thing. I remember when I came to America newly, the first picnic we went to. So that day, my husband was going to go to work. So I went with my daughter. No, the second picnic. So either second or third picnic, I went with my daughter. So Nelson was going to work. So Nelson dropped me. And there was a guy that used to date one of our neighbors. So he was at the picnic. My husband said, hey, I need to go sleep because I'm going to work that night. So I just dropped them by 4 o'clock. I need to go sleep. Please keep an eye on her. Make sure you know, get her food and stuff to eat. So keep an eye on her for me. I'm going to come back by 8 o'clock and pick her up. So my husband left. So the guy got a chair. We sat down. So when it was time to go get meat, that time he bought, you know, a picnic, he went and he got me meat and brought me. Then he went and got Casey some hamburger, brought Casey. He went back again and got us something to drink, brought. So, and I was sitting with my Casey was maybe about 2 years old. So we were sitting there, we were talking. He was sitting across from me. We were talking and laughing. So somebody came and said hi to me. People were coming and say, hey, where is Nelson? I say, he's sleeping. He has to go to work. Today, my husband never told me who the person was. But somebody went and called my husband and told my husband, hey, where are you? Nelson said, oh, I'm at home sleeping. Why? He said, your wife is here talking to this guy. Since I came to the picnic, I've been watching your wife. She and this guy, they've been talking. The guy went and got her some meat. The guy even carried your daughter. You know, you better come here now. Your wife, you know, your wife is young and pretty before somebody. Nelson was like, don't worry, I know who the guy is. What do you mean you know who the guy is? Okay, describe the guy. So my husband said, no, you describe the guy. So he described, I didn't know all this. So he described the guy. My husband said, don't worry, I know the guy. He said, you see, you have a problem. You trust too much. Nelson said, he didn't want to get off the phone. And I was sleeping. I said, you know what? Take your phone to Akudo. So the guy brought the phone to me. So when he brought, it was late at night that he now told me that's why the guy brought the phone. Mm-hmm. So I now know who the person is. So he said, the guy got the phone to me. He said, Ne, how are you doing? I said, fine. He said, are you still sitting with the guy? I said, yes. He said, have you guys eaten? I said, yes. He said, okay. So give the guy the phone. Let me talk to him. So I gave the guy the phone. So he said, so how are you doing? He said, I'm trying, you know, I've fed them all. I've given them food. He said, I know. I just wanted to say thank you. I will soon be there. So he now told the guy to give the other guy the phone. So the guy took the phone and walked away. So when Nelson now came to pick us up, Nelson started smiling. I said, what are you smiling about? He told me, he said, you see, you have to be very careful. Because people can cause trouble without you knowing it. He said, somebody, do you know that guy called me to tell me he has been watching you? You've been laughing with this guy. He's been by giving you meat and everything. And I kept telling him, I know. I told him to take care of you. And he kept telling me, why are you being this lame, having this laissez-faire attitude? Come on, this, that, that. So that's it. I laughed. I said, oh, I will never speak to that man again. I said, and I was so nice to that man. Yeah. And this is how he paid me back. I will never
speak. And that was totally unnecessary.
But the reason why I told that story is because be sure of what you're saying before you start running to go tell.
Yes, exactly.
Don't assume. Don't imagine. Don't think. Make sure you are concrete with your information. That's number one. Number two, before you tell your friend, talk to your friend's husband or your friend's wife. Nne, why are you cheating on your husband?
Mm.
Why are you dating this man?
Yes.
Why are you doing this? This man is so nice. This man is so good with you. This is your family. Talk to the girl. And if the girl, and tell the girl, you have to stop this or I will. Mm. Tell her, I will tell your husband. I will tell your husband because now I'm sure of what I'm talking about. But it is hard to give this kind of information because you might go and give the man or the woman and you become, like she said, you're their greatest enemy.
Yes.
They will call you enemy of progress.
Prophet of doom. Satan.
Satanic agent.
Agent of demon.
Demonic agent.
Evil. Evil.
No. My friend said, Akudo, when the Bible says wickedness in the high places, what do you think the Bible is talking about? Is these people?
It's Satan, principalities and powers. Two, there are two. Principalities and then wickedness in
the high places. So my sister, don't go share news that you're not sure of. And moreover too, your girlfriend, if she is in bliss, she is in heaven, she is enjoying herself, she doesn't even at that time believe that her husband is cheating. Why do you want to go bust her bubble?
Yes, you don't have to do that.
What would you gain by going to go bust her bubble?
And again, it depends on intention. You see, some people give this news
out of Obi Iwe.
Yeah.
Obi Ojo.
So somebody calls you and say, girl, I told you that man is not what? You said it so.
It's not good for
yes,
you.
Yes, you said so, it so. Yeah, you just want to be proven right.
Yeah, okay, you're right. Congratulations. Bravo. Bravo to you.
Bravo.
Bravo. The truth of the matter is that most of the time, we women do it just because I am not happy. Should you be happy?
Right.
So you remember there was a story that my sister that lives in Houston told us, you know,
mm-hmm.
This was two best friends. One was a divorced, she was divorced. Her friend was not divorced.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they are very good friends. So when her husband, her ex-husband died, so everybody rallied around her mm-hmm. to help her and her, you know. So this man was the man that was taking food to her. Her best friend was her husband was taking food, you know, caring for her and everything. But every day she will come and tell her girlfriend, your husband is cheating on you.
Mm-hmm.
I keep seeing him in this hotel that is close to Bissonnette. Mm-hmm. Every time he's in, you can say, no, my husband, maybe he's cheating. I'm not saying he doesn't cheat,
mm-hmm.
but I'm saying, my husband, when does he have time to cheat on me?
Yeah,
he said, no, your husband is cheating. So that particular day, the guy was sick since Friday. Didn't even go to work on Friday. So on Saturday morning, she was in her house cooking breakfast for her husband. Her girlfriend knocked. She opened the door because her husband works night. She opened the door. The girl said, I told you, I just passed now and I saw your husband's car.
Yes.
Your husband's car is right there with a woman in that hotel.
Yes.
I cannot believe this. The woman said, are you serious? He said, yes. The woman said, okay. Are you going to go take me to the hotel so mm-hmm. I can see? She said, yes. It's okay. Let me go get dressed. Come on. Let's go to the room. Let me go get dressed. She took the girl to her bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
And when they got to her bedroom, her husband was laying down on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
The girl was like, ah, who is that? He said, that's my husband. The man you saw at Bissonnette.
Mm-hmm.
The man you just saw right now at the hotel. Mm-hmm. That's him laying down there. And the girl said, oh, I'm so sorry. But no, she did it intentionally.
Evil. Satan of
wickedness in the high places. They will tell you stories. They will make up things just to make sure that your happiness, your bubble is, they bust it open. Mm-hmm. So it's less for you to know what is real and what is not real. Because most women, you see, if my husband cheat, I will leave. If my husband cheat on me, I will leave.
Take it.
Their husband will say, they say, well, I have forgiven him.
Their husband brings women into their homes. Tell me, nobody can cheat on me. Your husband will cheat on you the first time. Second, I forgive that time.
Because
you're not going to pray to somebody to forgive.
Because this, most of us women, we like to say things to look tough outside. Yes. But when we come back home, it's a whole different ballgame. Right. They want to, you know, I control that man. I do. When the man say jump, they say how high. The man say sit, they say how low. But when they see their friends, they want to act like, well,
I don't and I don't even understand why. Because what works for A
does cannot work for B. What works in my house cannot work in her house. Because we are married to two different men.
True.
We are living in two different homes. Mm-hmm. So what would so it doesn't matter. Why do you need to impress that lady and make her feel like you're the boss when you are not the boss? You are nothing. You are just a simple woman that loves your wife and loves your home, but you want to make them feel like you are this tough, you know, tough woman. So my sister, my brother, that is the last topic. Should you, girl code did not reach there. Before you start blabbing your mouth to your friend on who is cheating, be sure of what you're saying. Talk to the person first of all and tell the person, stop this or I'm going to tell my friend. And when you tell your friend, know how you present it. You don't present it like, girl,
I told you. I told you that
man is so good for you.
He wasn't good.
He has been cheating on you. I told you, you didn't believe me. No, it depends on the approach, how you say it. Honey, you know, talk to your husband. I saw your husband here or whatever. Don't even say you saw him with a girl. I saw your husband.
Are you guys, I would really say something in the line of, are you guys okay?
Are you guys okay? Are you happy? Yeah. Because I saw your husband at this hotel, but he said he came there with his friend, but I don't know what's going on. You know, just talk to your husband. You know, talk to your husband and then, but if you feel like you're, and you say it and your friend say, oh, no, that's not my husband. Leave it at that.
Yes.
Don't go proving it. Gimme. I even took pictures, Papa. Show me at the video.
Don't be like those satanic people again who say, ha! Madam Nketi. The other day I saw your husband at the bar. No, that must have been your sister, right? Gossiping about him. Who sent you? Who sent you? It's like you came with your husband that day at the club, but it's like you left before I came in because I just saw your husband and your sister. That must be your sister,
right?
Right.
And then the girl will say, oh no, that's not my husband. Maybe you look like my husband. So, you say, okay, hold on. Let me show you. Mm. Is this not the picture of your husband? Mm. I even videoed you. What are you videoing? Do you work for NBC News?
Evil satanic agents.
Do you work for ABC channel? What are you videoing and keeping record of? What are you going to do with it? Mm. Even if this woman decides to leave this marriage, are you going to be her lawyer in court? Mm. I don't understand.
Hello, girl. Where are you? Where is you, girl? I'm at the 445. I saw your man with another woman. Hurry up and get on, girl, and bring some grease.
What are you going to do?
Yes, because you know what Pastor said in church today? Once they apply Vaseline on their face. If you know why people apply Vaseline and grease on their face before they fight, please tell me.
Tell me.
I don't know.
But the truth of the matter, you know, forget that we're joking, but this is the truth of the matter.
True, yeah.
You know, this girl code is good, but it's not one size fits all. You see the difference? We've talked about girl code, girlfriend. We talked about sister code. We have talked about cheating. Should you tell? We've talked about so many things. When you go out with your friends, do you go home with them? There are so many other sister codes. There are so many other sister codes we can follow. When you go out with your friends, make sure you come back together. When you drop your friends, make sure you wait until they enter their houses. Make sure you tell your friends when they're looking good. Do not criticize them. Be honest with them. Be truthful with them. There are so many other girl codes we can observe.
Yeah, I will tell you people one.
But the only thing we want to observe is tell your girlfriend when her man is cheating and do not date their ex. That's not the only two we talk about.
I'm going to give you people one. When somebody breaks your friend's heart, kill them.
No, you can't say that.
Sorry.
You know, so, but that is the truth of the matter. The truth of the matter is that you have to No, use your, like she said, use common sense. You cannot say because, I saw your man. I saw, I could, guess what? I saw Nelson with somebody that is fair. I think it's your sister. Nelson is sitting on here with your sister. This is my sister. She looks like me. Mm-hmm. Most of the time in Nigeria, people see her and they think she's me. And they'll be asking, how is Nelson?
How are the kids? I said, they're all fine. They're fine. They're doing
And
this.
There are people that see me here and they start talking to me thinking I'm her.
Yes.
And I just listen and I will. So tomorrow, you... Don't say what you don't know. Sure. Yes. Don't say what you're not sure.
You might ruin a life.
You want to ruin a family. Yes. You want to ruin a home with assumption, with what you think, with what you presume. No. Keep your gossiping self to yourself.
Keep your mouth to yourself.
Keep your mouth to yourself. Not with these children. Keep your hands and feet to yourself. We should be telling adults, keep your mouth to yourself. Girl code is good. Sister code is good. Boy code is good, brotherly code is good, but let us know how we do
apply
it.
Wisdom.
Let us apply wisdom. Don't put so many barriers around you and thinking you're giving yourself girl code. And it's only, instead of it being a stepping stone, it's becoming a stumbling block. It's stopping you. You cannot date somebody from this race. You cannot date somebody from this. What if that is where the rib of your rib is? What are you going to do about it? Any final thing before we leave?
Well, not much. The Bible says that wisdom is profitable to direct.
Exactly.
So apply wisdom, apply common sense. Don't go and rain on somebody's parade. Don't go and make somebody unhappy just because you can't find yours. Sometimes also learn to mind your business.
That's right.
But above all, be your sister's keeper. Mm-hmm. Watch out for your sister. Celebrate your sister. If your friend or your sister is going out there and getting it, celebrate them. Be happy for them.
Be happy for them.
Be happy for their success. All right. We tear ourselves up
apart
because of hatred, because of envy. My sister's success is my success.
Exactly.
My friend's success is my success. Mm-hmm. Be happy for them. And most times when you all got, I know that most women, most times when we gather, there's always this temptation to just want to talk about men. Mm. Oh, this man did this, this man did. Sometimes with my friend or with my friends, what we want to talk about is, what's the next big move? Mm-hmm. What is the next big career
move?
How do we achieve? How do we do this thing right, you know? Mm-hmm. So be your sister's keeper. Watch out for your sister. Get your sister's back. Don't let a man come in between you and your best
sister.
Friend.
Yeah.
Right? We say that in some cases you might date your ex or whatever, but don't let somebody you don't know come and ruin your life, your lifelong relationship. Don't do that, all right? Mm-hmm. Love yourself, be happy, drink lots of water, smile, and you'll probably look as pretty as we do.
All right, my uniques. I wanted to come to you guys. Remember what we said. Sister code, girl code is necessary. Brother code, dude code, guy code is necessary. But you have to do it with common sense. Do that which you benefit from, which is profitable for you. But when it comes to girl code of dating, you can date depending on how you're dating. Make sure you are not intentionally breaking up relationships so that they cannot come and date you because you don't care about girl code. No. But if they have broken up and they have moved on and that guy comes for you and that guy is the rib of your rib and flesh of your flesh, go ahead and date them. Please. And remember, all these rules you put around yourself, you're only limiting yourself. You just a little while. Life is too short. You need to be happy. You need to be happy. Take care of yourself. And sisters, the greatest girl code I know is being each other's keepers. Rejoice when you see your sister going up. Rejoice when you see your sister doing well. When you see them going down, that is not the time to laugh and say, I told them they will go down. Find a way to lift your sister up. We are the only gender. Men are not like us. Men get each other's back. We are the only gender that we are always going at each other. Oh, why would they progress? Why? We are just like the crab. We are all in the barrel. Nobody's going to leave. When you try to leave, we pull you down. We can't all stay down. But if we come and stack on each other, we will go out of that barrier one at a time. One at a time, and all of us will be gone. So let us be our sister's keeper. Let us love one another. Let us encourage one another and celebrate each other. Let us celebrate each other and accept each other for who we are and what we can do. Every single one of us, we are bringing something to the table. I might not be as creative as you. I might not sing, although I've been asking God to give me a singing voice. That one, God is not giving it to
me. Leadership says.
But you people are still going to deal with this, my voice. No. Whether you like it by fire, by thunder.
Just like I can dance. Leadership also says.
You know, but celebrate those that can sing. Celebrate those that can dance. If you can't do it, it's okay. There is something you're good at. Find your passion. Find that thing you love and you can excel in. And let us celebrate that. Let us be each other. The greatest girl code is being each other's keeper. Remember to give us a thumbs up, share this video, and please subscribe to the channel. I need you to come join my family. Remember, you are beautifully and wonderfully made by God. That is why you are unique. Be kind to yourself and to each other. Bye-bye.